Okay, guys, in addition to what I just showed you with the cut tool, I'm going to show you some other techniques for getting nice wrinkles and subtle variation in your furniture, cushions, and pillows, those kind of things. So let's just make another pillow here real quick. And this will just be for demonstration purposes, so I won't go into the full detail of making a cushion, but I will show you the techniques you need to do what I'm going to do. So I'm just going to take that, extrude it, convert it to an edit poly, and then let's just connect it. We'll say 8 times, 9 times. Do it again this direction. That's good. Now I'm going to take this outside line here and loop it to select all the outside lines on the pillow, or I guess cushion, top and bottom. Make sure you get them all. We're going to chamfer them. Just like that. And then this is where the new technique comes in. Let me work it out here for you. So we have that cushion selected. We're going to put a cloth modifier on it in the modifier panel. Go to the object properties. Rectangle 3 is going to be our cloth object. We want to use a default or a preset of cotton. And then there's this cool setting in the cloth modifier if you've never used it before, but there's a pressure setting. You just hit OK. And what that does is it kind of inflates this cushion. So let's set our gravity to 0 so it just sits there. And we'll just hit simulate. You can see that thing inflate. It's going a little crazy. We might have to change our settings a little bit. That's what we got. If you pan or scrub back and forth, really all that was doing is filling up that cushion like a balloon, which is pretty cool. And we might just leave it kind of like that. That's fine. Okay, and so if you have something you like here, and you could mess with the settings more and get something crazy, but I think I'm okay with just that right there. I'll just convert it to edit poly in that state. Now we can start cutting just like we did on this other pillow, or this other cushion. So let me go ahead and start doing that a little bit. Actually, I've promised that I would show a little bit of the graphite tools up here. So let's use the P-Connect to do this cutting. The way you do that is you click and hold on an edge and then just go to another edge. While you're holding down, you just go from edge to edge and it will connect it. So that's what that looks like. Looks like I screwed up here on the end. Just cut that. And then like I showed you in another video, just start taking that. Select those vertices. Move them down on the Z-axis, kind of like that. Let's see how that turbosmith is real quick. Get a little preview of it. That's pretty nice. I got something weird going on over here, but yeah, I don't want that. Let's remove that. Okay, there's a nice little wrinkle. I'm just going to go through and do some more of these, and then I'm going to show you the cloth modifier again to add even more variation to this. Okay, as you can see, I've added in a few manual cuts here and some wrinkles, like I showed you in the previous video, which is all fine, but we still need to make it nicer. So what we're going to do is use the cloth modifier a little bit more. Let's isolate this real quick. Let's take a simple rectangle, put it underneath this. This will act as our ground plane so that that pillow has something to collide into. Okay, and let's take both of these and add a new cloth modifier to them. Let's name these so we can properly know what each thing is when we go into that modifier. So if we go into here, object properties, cushion, we'll set this as the cloth and we'll put it on silk so it can get really wrinkly. Set the pressure to 0.5. And then the rectangle we'll set to inactive and collision object, just like that. And the only other thing is the gravity. I don't want the gravity to be too powerful. The default is negative 980. So I'm going to set it to 100, negative 100. And we're just going to simulate that, and that will add a bunch of cloth looking effects to our pillow. And right where our wrinkles are, we should get a little more natural looking wrinkles. Okay, I can cancel it here. I don't think I'm going to use all of that. No, I let it run to the end anyway. Okay, so now you can go through here, find the spot where you think it's best. I think maybe somewhere. Now you can see the pressure is making the top of this bubble quite a bit, which I don't necessarily like in this situation. Those wrinkles I modeled in are mostly maintained. They're going to look a little more natural now that I've done the cloth modifier. So this is kind of a soft fabric looking pillow, which is fine. We'll go with that. Now you can take an edit poly modifier and put it on top. Find where you want your seam to be. I'll use this loop here. This will be a clean one. So we'll loop that around like that. And then we will, let's go to the front view. It'll let me. Wow. Maybe that is the front view. No? Okay. Let's select that again. Okay, my hotkey's not working. It's okay. Let's do it from this side. Let's do soft selection and select some of the area around that seam. And actually, let's go hold down control and hit vertices, so we switch to vertices. That's not what I wanted. Okay, go to edge. Hold down control and hit that. That'll select all the vertices that were along those edges. Make sure to go to soft selection. And then I'm gonna kind of scale those in a non-uniform way. Make sure non-uniform scale is selected. Lock in your selection and scale in the Y to kind of flatten out the seam. Like that. That's good. We don't want too much variation in that seam. Let's go back to the edge, take off soft selection. And this is where we can do our normal extrude. sort of like that. And that'll just give us that little stitching seam there. Put the turbo smooth back on for the first time. You can see we still have some nice little wrinkles. Our model is very efficient. And we've got some nice detail. And then we have those subtle variations in there caused by that cloth modifier. And that's a really soft looking, nice pillow. And look how efficient that is. The wrinkles are right here and they're more tessellated, and then it just fans out into this less tessellation area where we don't have that high of detail. So that's a really nice model of kind of a soft fabric cushion. And you can see it sitting perfectly flat on that ground because that was all part of the cloth reaction. Obviously, the more time and detail you put into the manual modeling and cutting of the wrinkles, the better effect you'll get up here in front. And the rest of it is just the same stuff we've watched in all the videos with the simple extrude and the turbo smooth. So hopefully that is another tool you can add to your arsenal of furniture modeling techniques. There's a lot of other things that you can do with the cloth modifier. Use your imagination. I'll do a few more videos in the future of how to make couch cushions and throw pillows, those kind of things, with the cloth modifier. There's a lot you can do with it to add these nice subtle variations that look very natural. So experiment with that and stay tuned for more videos coming later.